to talk about Trey Waynes and him suffering a pectoral injury and whether or not he will miss the season and what this means. But before we get into it, let's hear a brief sponsor from my man D Loyal. Be sure to check out his information. His page is in the description. This is real, most definitely. I feel like a college professor. Woke up today, I'm blessed. 20 a G, no stress. Cognac, I'm Mitchell and Ness. Now I'm faded from the vapors. I was raised as a Bengal, but I was born as a Raider. Welcome to New Stripe City, a YouTube channel for diehard Bengals fans. I'm your host, Ace Boogie, and welcome to the new viewers and the returning diehard subs to the channel. We do weekly interviews here and provide analysis on the latest Bengals breaking news. So if you're new here, please consider subscribing. And if you want to know how to subscribe, there's a button below this video, and we also provide a link in the video description. So if you're looking for that, it should be there. So it's Tuesday morning and I'm recording this, and this wasn't what we expected waking up this morning, is to news that Trey Waynes is seeking a second opinion on his pectoral injury. Why is that major? Because Trey Waynes was one of the biggest free agent signings for the Bengals this offseason. You know, they waited and spent a lot of money on him, 3 years, $42 million. There was some issues with like his contract with him not signing and stuff like that, but they got past that once COVID was over and once he reported, they were able to sign him. Now, this was a guy that they brought in to really be an upgrade from Drake Kirkpatrick, meaning that some people felt that he was overpaid, whether it was Vikings fans, whether it was some Bengals fans, because he was essentially a faster Drake Kirkpatrick, a guy that, you know, would have some lapses in time to time in coverage, but overall was solid. But some people felt like, you know, he really was just an upgraded version of Drake Kirkpatrick that could tackle better, essentially. That's no shot to Dre or anything like that, but I mean, that's pretty valid. He was good at tackling. However, he did have lapses in coverage similar to Dre. But the big issue here is that the Bengals go out and shell out a lot of money, and then they get hit with another free agent that ends up getting hurt after they sign him to a big contract. So what does this mean? To me, I think that is somewhat of a blow to the secondary. But to me, a lot of us and Bengals fans who frequent this page already know about Darius Phillips. So the fact that they have Darius Phillips waiting in the wings, I think that Bengals fans are more than confident that he can come in and definitely contribute, being that he had a very solid year last season. I think 4 interceptions. And a lot of us want to see more of Darius Phillips. But the thing is, there's going to be that sour taste in your mouth where you're starting to think about Antonio Brian and, you know, these things. And in my personal opinion, I think that Trey Waynes is going to end, this is probably likely going to end his season, because if you remember when William Jackson III was a rookie, he sustained the same injury around the same time and missed his full rookie season. So I wouldn't expect Trey Waynes to play in 2020. And I mean, with this season being the coronavirus and stuff like that, I mean, this is probably potentially a season that may not even end up finishing. So, you know, it's better that he has this injury now than later. Now, he is 28 years old. This is a lot of money that the Bengals have committed to him. So I don't have the exact details to determine what he's actually owed and, you know, what stipulations are put in there for injuries and stuff like that. So this is definitely a tremendous loss to the secondary, because, you know, if they have any kind of injuries this year, it hurts them. But this actually, I think, helps William Jackson's case for the most part, with him going into a contract year. You know, this gives him a chance to really establish himself and earn some of that money. So we'll have to see what happens from that standpoint. But Trey Waynes, I expect him to really miss the season. I mean, I'm not a doctor or anything, but this is the same injury, if I'm not mistaken, that William Jackson had his rookie season. So I think that that's going to keep him out. What does this mean going forward? I think the fact that the Bengals were a player in free agency and ended up also signing Mackenzie Alexander, I think that that helps. I'm not sure if this means that they will go out and sign another corner with Darqueze Dennard signing already. Drake Kirkpatrick is still out there, so there is a potential that he could come back. So looking at the Trey Waynes contract, it looks like he was guaranteed at least $15 million just to sign. So that is, I'm assuming, $15 million that's going to be down the hatch there. So unfortunately, they do have to give him that money, but we'll have to see what happens. I mean, it's a bad situation, but like I said, this does open the door, I think, for Drake or Patrick to come back. I think that the Bengals still have some solid options out there at corner. By no means do I think that they're in a real big pickle at the position, but I think given that you had Trey Waynes there, I think if there's any injuries at the position, you felt more comfortable with having Trey Waynes there, and you kind of wanted to see what he could do, if he could actually live up to that contract. So the first year of the contract has already been, you know, pretty much deemed a disaster. But we'll have to see, you know, next season and season after that, whether he's going to bounce back and what will happen. So it's a bad situation. There's no sugarcoating it. This doesn't mean that the Bengals made a mistake by going after guys in free agency. Injuries happen. You know, it's part of the game. And so the Bengals just have to bounce back from this. And I think that they will. I think that they'll be just fine. It'll give us another look at Darius Phillips, give us a better look at what William Jackson III can do, and whether or not, you know, we need to keep Trey Waynes or move on or restructure. So we'll have to see how these things plan out. But with that said, let me know what you guys think in the comments. And as usual, I'll leave you with a who day all day, every day, and especially on Sunday. New Stripe City is proud to announce that our channel has partnered with Fanatics, an NFL licensed merchandiser for NFL.com and Bengals.com as well. Through Fanatics, you can buy men's and women's and kids' Bengals apparel and jerseys, and also help grow our channel through using the links in our video description. When you do that, it truly helps grow the channel, and we did this because it allows Bengals fans to not only enjoy our content, but also get top-tier authentic Bengals merchandise. So if you're looking to get a new Burrow or T. Higgins jersey, or even a fresh hoodie or a hat, click on the link in our description, and when you do that, it helps support the channel. Now, when you order a rookie's jersey, and that by rookie, I mean Joe Burrow or T. Higgins, it's a special event item, meaning that the NFL has to confirm rookie jersey numbers first before sending it out for production and shipment. And also with COVID-19, it also has slowed this process down as well. So one thing that you'll notice is that you may receive an initial delivery date of October, but that is due to those restrictions. I've been told by Fanatics' support team that once jersey numbers are confirmed and the supply is received, that the item will immediately ship out, meaning that you can expect to get your item sooner than October. However, if you have any questions about your order or when it's going to be shipped or any details, you can reach out to the Fanatics support team on Twitter at Fanatics Support. You can direct message them with your order number and they will give you an update on it. But your jersey is covered for up to 365 days. And this is something that applies to whether you buy it on NFL.com's NFL shop or the Bengals Pro Shop online. We all are under these restrictions. So bear with us. We appreciate it. And as usual, make sure that you're rocking with us on Who Day, all day, every day, and especially on Sunday.